Hello everyone and welcome back to Brooke's Beauty Bazaar. My name is Brooke and in today's video, I am bringing you another brand overview. Yes, that's right. I am going to be sharing with you all of the fungal acne safe products available at bareMinerals. Roll the footage. So stay tuned because I am saving the product that I am most excited about for last. Feel free to take a moment and comment what you think that product might be right now. Otherwise, let's do this. Now, you may not be that excited about bareMinerals, and you're probably also not gonna be surprised by a lot of the product options that are available to you. However, can we just take one moment to give bareMinerals credit where credit is due? They have taken the time to bring us natural and clean beauty products with non-toxic, safe ingredients, and you just never get that with fungal acne. So really, they deserve a round of applause for this, do they not? Everyone, applaud. That being said, if you are one of my natural beauty lovers out there, this video is for you. So I took a trip to my Ulta to see how much of this product range was actually available there, and it was shocking how much they actually had. You're gonna end up seeing some of the B-roll footage from that trip, and you will notice that everything there is saran wrapped. That is just a result of going shopping during a pandemic at a beauty store, but I'm just glad to know that they're keeping us safe and the selection was incredible. So bareMinerals actually now offers a skincare line in addition to their makeup products, and only two of those products are actually going to be fungal acne safe. The reason for that is simply because when you have a brand that is natural and clean, you're going to get into having so many of those trigger ingredients like coconut, jojoba, olive, castor oils, all of that kind of stuff is going to be found in their products, and therefore so many of the items, even the acne range, is totally unsafe for us. And I also think it's really weird, okay? Just as an FYI, if you guys don't know this about me, I'm currently at cosmetology school finishing up my degree, and we are in a skincare section right now. I'm doing a skincare class right now, and as one of the things that is like common thread knowledge here, fatty acids feed bacterial acne, acne vulgaris, and those same fatty acids are what's feeding the Malassezia yeast on your skin. So I find it so strange that there are products out there in this world that are composed of all these fatty lipids and acids like olive oil and coconut oil, and they're marketed to people who have acne. It just makes no sense on any playing field. I had to let you guys know, because if you guys are as outraged about that whole thing as I am, feel free to go ahead and just leave an angry face emoji, but maybe put a nice one next to it so I don't get offended, okay? Enough jabbering, let me tell you about these products. We are gonna start out with the skincare items because there's only two to mention. If you are still on the hunt for a cleanser, bareMinerals has actually got you covered in this way. It is called the Blemish Remedy Acne Treatment Jelly Cleanser, so you can give that a go. They also have a Skin Longevity Green Tea Herbal Eye Mask. So if you are one of my masking babies, then feel free to go and pick those up. But I think you would also be interested to know there are a lot more masks available in the Sephora collection, which I recently did a video on, and I'm gonna link it right now so you can check all those options out. So we are gonna go ahead and get into the makeup. Now, a lot of you guys comment on my videos asking if I know of a good primer, and let me tell you guys, I don't really use too much primer in my life, but if you are in the market for one, bareMinerals has two options. One is the Primetime Foundation Primer, and one is the Primetime Brightening Foundation Primer. So both of these are options for you. I will just quickly note, these do have vitamin E in them, and that can come from a soybean oil. So just be very cautious if you're gonna try these out. I would do a patch test with them first before you fully commit. And if they don't work out for you, then give them to one of your friends who could use them safely with no issues. This will come as a surprise to no one. We are moving into foundations and we have two really solid options here. There is the original loose powder foundation with SPF 15, and then they also have the loose powder matte foundation with an SPF of 15. Now, the matte formulation does contain one amino acid that when mixed with lipids could potentially cause the growth of Malassezia. I don't see that that would be a major issue for most of us because we're usually steering clear of lipids altogether, but I suppose it could cause some harm if you were using maybe squalane oil as your base, but I don't know enough about that yet to say that. It's just a thought that I'm having, and I'll let you guys know when I find out more. Moving on to concealers, there is only one option for us here. It is the loose powder concealer with an SPF of 20. Now, there are only four shades in this, and I'm gonna be honest, I feel like with that shade range and the fact that it is basically just the same as the foundation with a little bit more SPF in it, I'd say pass right on this one. It just doesn't really make sense to me. So let's talk about some bronzers and highlighting options. Now there are two bronzers that they have available. They have the Warmth All Over, which is kind of their traditional bronzing item. I've used this one before and honestly, I really don't like it. So I wouldn't totally recommend it to you guys, but if you're looking for a bronzer and you haven't found one that you like that is also fungal acne safe, then this could be an option for you. They also make the Faux Tan All Over face color, and it does definitely get higher ratings than the All Over Warmth. Now, both of those only come in one shade, so I'm just letting you know this probably is not gonna work for every skin tone, but it is an option if you're looking for something like this. Now, in the highlighter range, they do have a little bit more positive stuff going on. With this product, I don't really think of this in a traditional sense of like highlighters that are just gonna give you that blinged out cheek, you know? This is going to be a product that's going to give you more of an overall like glowy radiance. They have three options. There is the Bare Radiance, the Pure Radiance, and the Flawless Radiance. And one more thing I wanted to mention within this category is the Well Rested Under Eye Brightener with an SPF of 20. Now this is one of those universal one shade products yet again from bareMinerals. So they're saying this works for a whole bunch of people. So this is actually marketed to be a dark circle concealer, and because it's supposed to conceal your dark circles and be a radiance under eye item, I feel like the one shade factor of this probably is going to work on a bulk of people. However, I don't know if it's too light to work on darker skin tones, so I wouldn't really spend my money here. Now, we have just covered our face in powder formulas, so I am going to place a high bet on the fact that you are not gonna wanna purchase this next product. However, if you do not have a finishing powder that you know and love, they do have one. It is the Mineral Veil Finishing Powder. It comes in four different shades. This product is probably gonna work better if you are using a liquid foundation. It does have zinc stearate and magnesium stearate in it. Both of those are completely unverified ingredients. They're not ones that I'm personally afraid of. So use at your own risk if you're gonna get this product. And if you guys need a recommendation for a really good liquid foundation, I'm gonna link that video right now and you can find one that works for you over there. So let's move into blush. Now, I was excited about this category because I have been using the Loose Mineral Blush for as long as I can remember, and I regularly have Golden Gate in my drawer so that I can use it as one of my two go-to blush options. But they now have a pressed powder blush that is absolutely fungal acne safe, and it comes in four shades. Now, you guys may have seen the Hailey Bieber ads going on for bareMinerals. She is the face of their Bounce and Blur line, and their Bounce and Blur blushes are fungal acne safe, and the colors are awesome. So obviously, if you wanna look like Hailey Bieber, all you need to do is buy that blush and apply it to your cheeks. Now, I definitely did save the best for last, but before I tell you guys what that item is, we are going to have a quick word from Past Brooke because she has an important message for us, and I will see you on the other side with the big reveal. Hey guys, Brooke here. I just wanted to drop a quick reminder that I struggled with acne for 17 years of my life, and it wasn't until I discovered fungal acne that I was able to clear my skin without the help of dermatologists, prescription drugs, harsh chemicals, or expensive products. If you want to find out the exact methods, products, and skincare routine I use to achieve these results, click the link in the down bar below to download my From Fungal Acne to Clear Skin guide. Just look for the green check marks. It's a one-stop, straightforward guide to help you navigate the world of makeup and skincare when you're dealing with fungal acne. Now back to you, President Brooke. All right, President Brooke is back, and are you guys hyped and ready for the big reveal? Do you wanna know what I'm totally going bonkers for? You guys, not only do they have 27 shades available in their Loose Mineral Eyeshadow, but now they also have made us not one, but three eyeshadow palettes, We are back to the Bounce and Blur product range, and they have created 3 eyeshadow palettes, all containing 5 shadows each, so that we can create beautiful, dynamic looks in one stop. Now, like I told you, there are 3 options here. So we've got Dawn, Dusk, and Horizon. The Horizon shade is a limited edition and it is currently on sale on their website. So if you wanna snatch that one up, I would go and try and get your hands on it now before it goes away. But Dawn is really calling my name because it looks like it could have some colors in it that would be a good dupe for the ABH Soft Glam palette, and I cannot wait to get my hands on it. By the way, those loose mineral eyeshadows are also absolutely beautiful. My twin sister uses the shade Celestine every single day, and I really love it on her. So if you guys want to see me talk about that product and several more amazing fungal acne eyeshadows, I am going to link my eyeshadow video right now so you can check it out. So we are in the home stretch, you guys. I just want to mention these one-off products that are technically fungal acne safe, but they're not ones that I'm going to be running to go and grab. If you haven't found a felt tip liquid eyeliner, because there's only 8,000 on the market for those of us suffering from fungal acne, bareMinerals has one. It is the Lash Domination Liquid Eyeliner Felt Tip Pen. It only comes in black. Now you know. They also have an eyebrow powder, and it's available in 4 shades. And then they also have a liner powder, and it is also available in 4 shades. But really, it's just another mineral product alternative. So if you guys really want it, then maybe look out for it. Now, if you guys are really into having a name brand brush cleaner and you really just need that in your collection, bareMinerals has also got you covered, and they are fungal acne safe. There are 2 options. So there is the Well Cared For brush cleaner, and then they also have the brush cleaner spray for kind of more casual in between brush uses. Now, I personally don't use a name brand brush cleaner at all. I use the Aveeno baby soap for mine, and if you guys want to see how I clean my brushes in the most efficient way possible, you can click on the link above right now because I have a video all about it. So I will definitely be including some of these products in the bar below. They're gonna be linked so you can shop them, but if you guys want to get the full list of all these products, then you should definitely check out my blog post on this topic. There will be links for you to shop there, and if you want to shop any other fungal acne safe products at the same time, you can do so on brooksbeautybazaar.com by clicking shop at the top of the page. Otherwise, come and say hi to me on Instagram at brooksbeautybazaar, where I hang out every single day. Tastes like solid dirt. If you're one of my masking babies, is babies okay to say? Miss Walker calls us her babies. Brightening foundation primer. That's a hard one to say. All right, present brack. Present brack is back. The end. All right. It's over. It's over. And my outfit has changed.